This is it, brother. The final push. Your squad's actions will dictate not only the future of the Brotherhood, but of the very wasteland itself. From here on out, you will have to scavenge supplies on your own. If you do set foot in this bunker again, it will be because the calculator is no more. Our technicians have secured our nuclear warhead to a vehicle for transport, which will be waiting for you on site. This warhead will be needed to crack an entrance into Vault Zero. I know it sounds like overkill, but that vault is designed to take several direct nuclear hits, and our only hope is that a precise nuclear blast directed on the door will do the job. We expect the entrance to be heavily protected, so make sure that your squad is ready for some heavy action. You must ensure that the warhead stays safe until detonated. The calculator will not give us such an opportunity again. Once you activate the bomb, you should immediately seek worthy shelter. Duck and cover isn't going to cut it this time. Power armor should help to further aid your survival within the bunker. Remember, you will practically be at ground zero of the resulting nuclear explosion. Be sure to take your anti-radiation medication. It was an honor to work with you, brother. Dismissed.
In the paranoid times leading up to the war, new vaults were being constructed every day. The ancient temples of war known as NORAD became the home for Vault Zero, a storage place for the cryogenically frozen geniuses of the time. The calculator was built to be a mixture of machine and man, a gestalt of mechanical switches and human brains linked through a cybernetic interface. Supposedly, representing the ideal society, these brains were to govern the higher functions of the calculator, powering its neural network. The calculator was designed to oversee the repopulation of the continent in the event of a war, and educate the new humanity in the ways of the old world. But first, it was to sterilize the land, making a fresh start for the soon-to-be emerging citizens of Neo-America. For this task, the calculator had at its disposal an army of emergency pacification robots that were designed to survive the Holocaust and surface from the ashes immediately after to begin their task. But a mechanical malfunction left the calculator damaged during the years since the bombs dropped. Mankind had to find its own ways in the darkness of the post-apocalypse. Only now is the calculator activating its robots and embarking on its mission of mass genocide. Because of hardwired programming, it is unable to adapt to the world that has arisen while it slumbered. The calculator will not listen to pleas or threats. It cannot be bargained with. It must be stopped.
Committee rules 30-3 in favor of streamlining Vault Zero's computer backup system costs from $24 billion to $2.3 billion. These cuts will take place immediately. This ruling was based on the dwindling chance for actual nuclear war taking place, along with much-needed pay increases to senior committee members. Furthermore, the subterranean vault compartments that were designated for backup computer and life support systems will now be renovated for senior vault personnel leisure facilities. The committee has a construction agenda that must be finalized by mid-March. The new facility options are as follows. Several top-quality restaurants with 10,000 square feet of cold storage, 7 smoke rooms with piano bars, and 2 subterranean hunting grounds stocked with rare animals purchased from world-renowned zoos. All of these are feasible, but require an additional $12.4 billion, which can be acquired by... Good question, Dr. Jones. I would be happy to explain why we're taking the path less traveled when compared to mundane computer systems. One advantage the calculator has over normal computers is the electro-organic linking terminal. Our tests conclude that the CPU can share tasks and receive data from pseudo-cryogenic stored brains that are maintained in an oxygenated tank. These brains are currently that of lab rodents, but our calculations indicate that human brains can be preserved in the same fashion. The brains will be fed specifically formulated nutrients to sustain suspended life. In turn, they will assist the calculator's CPU in vault management, including life support, food production and distribution, pacification robot protocol, and Vault Zero defenses. This neural network will also assist in Vault Zero's primary function, to initiate mankind's post-war rebirth, when outside temperature, radiation levels, and poison particle counts return to acceptable levels, Vault Zero will remotely activate the Exodus protocol, which will initialize the integration of all Vault dwellers onto the planet's surface. The brains are to be harvested from a select group of geniuses that were chosen by committee for their skills and their cute haircuts.
This is Third Scientist Lewis with a report on the cause for the perimeter alarm. Late last night, a heavily armed group of mutated humans attempted to force their way into the vault. I've never seen such creatures. The smallest one was over 7 feet tall and must have weighed at least 400 pounds. I believe that this group has seen fighting recently. Each one was carrying enough firepower to arm a small platoon. But the real shock came when a security camera was able to get a close-up. These poor creatures are severely mutated, with the majority of their features only vaguely resembling that of human beings. I don't know if they're a product of nuclear radiation. They seem to share too many similarities with their muscle-bound frames to credit a random mutation. Their intrusion in the vault has fully woken up the calculator, and the emergency pacification protocol has been initiated. I don't believe the invading mutants were expecting to combat a behemoth, but the results were...
Thank you. nuclear bomb armed and activated. Thank you for purchasing a product from Manhattan Projects Incorporated. To hear the countdown in French, please press 1. To hear the countdown in Spanish, please press 2. To hear the countdown in Southern drawl, please press 3. If you are listening to this message, Manhattan Projects Incorporated recommends that you run, seek shelter, and duck and cover. Have a nice day.
The warhead did the job, and the way inside Vault Zero is clear. Now get in there and finish the job. Well done, Warrior. You have breached Vault Zero's outer perimeter. From here, you must confront and destroy the calculator. Dagger Squad was deployed earlier to clear the way for you, but expect heavy resistance from the robots. This is a winner-take-all situation. Hold on, brother.
Sir, 6 behemoths and a large number of pacification robots have slipped in on North Perimeter. It looks like the calculator is going for broke.
Very well, Initiate. Bring up the tank to the north side and sound the alarm. Recall all patrols ASAP.
Yes, sir.
We have a situation here, brother. You eliminate the calculator and get home. We'll make sure that you have a home to come back to. General Decker, out.
Well met, Warrior. We're going to mop up any resistance up here and guard your tail. Good luck taking out the calculator. And don't take any unnecessary chances in there. The wasteland's future rides on your shoulders.
Warning. Outer perimeter breach. Outer perimeter breach. Main power generator now offline. Emergency power engaged. Toilets offline. Sections A5, A6, A9. Vault technician notified. Have a nice day. Thank you for activating Vault Zero Information Terminal. It is 75 degrees with 20% humidity. Information download to Pip-Boy Computer Map Directory complete. Have a nice day.
With the information from the terminal, proceed into the Western Security Wing. Attempt to find a path into the cryogenics or power plant wings.
Thank you. Thank you.
This terminal has unlocked the cryogenics wing. It is our hope that hidden somewhere in this area is a method of entry to the power plant. Proceed with caution, brother.
Thank you for activating Vault Zero Access Terminal. Security locks on Hazardous Weapons Storage Bay G03A05 have been removed. All guards have been informed to allow you access. Have a nice day.
It appears that the interior defense generators are still online. You will need to deactivate them before you can enter the inner power plant. Find these generators and take them offline, brother. Excellent work, brother. With the security generators down, you can now gain access to the power nodes. Victory is close. Thank you. Power has been restored to the transport system. It is time to move to the elevator and enter the calculator's main lair.
Thank you. That's far enough, warrior. Can you recognize me now? Even in my new form? You've come a long way since my departure, but you haven't come far enough. The Brotherhood has caused many setbacks for us recently. But that's all they are. Just setbacks. You cannot stop the future. Just as you can't stop falling rain from reaching the ground. The Calculator offers humanity a world of order and peace. A world free of war, of mutants and chaos. The Brotherhood would be wise to realize that their cause has been tainted by misdirection and genetic mutation, but they can still save themselves if they stop trying to prevent the unavoidable. However, you are too close to my new master and salvation to be allowed to continue. I salute you, warrior, but this is where your mission ends. What are my scanners detecting? A mere trinket?
My holidays. To my wife.
Maria?
What? What have I done? I've almost forgotten you, my love. I will not hinder you anymore, warrior, at least until I'm able to sort out this conflict between my new programming and these revived feelings. I need time to think, to remember my Maria.
Thank you.
Intruder alert. Intruder alert. Countermeasures activated. Defense systems engaged.
Thank you. Greetings. I am the Calculator, overseer of the Vault Network. You have proven to be a statistical anomaly that crashed my logistics programs time and time again. It is my admiration of your adaptation and ingenuity that brings you to me. I assume that you would agree that 10 behemoth robots would terminate you and your squad. I have the resources to make such an offensive, but it is not in my interest. After all, you are quite the remarkable human, and more importantly, you have something I need. It is the organic portion of my mainframe that has become corrupted. The degeneration of my symbiotic brains has corrupted 85% of main protocol programming. It would take only one brain to bring my organic subsystems back online, but finding a feasible brain has become a problem. I would use a brain from one of Vault Zero's residents, but I compute that my CPU would only become less efficient. However, there is another solution. Yours is a brain that can bring balance to my organic neural network. I am offering you what humans call a dream come true. You can shed your mortal shell and join with me. You will share my power and resources to save humanity and restore civilization from the smoking ruins of the wasteland. Your name will never be forgotten and be synonymous with the word hero. What say you, warrior? Will you continue to fight me? Destroy me and continue to carve some small, insignificant niche for the Brotherhood? While the Brotherhood may tame a region, they will never have the lasting impact I alone can. The machinery you see before you has the capacity to remove your brain from its mortal vessel. It is in this machine that your journey to save mankind will truly begin. You must hurry, human. My systems cannot function long without a symbiotic brain.
When the acrid smoke clears, nothing remains of the entity known as the Calculator, except burnt wires and broken valves. It is a decisive victory for humanity, for at the crucial point in the raging battle, the robots were stopped dead in their course of destruction. The warrior can only ponder on the lost opportunity that the destruction of such a technological marvel represents. History has shown that even the victors of battle have some regrets, but sometimes one must move forward. The Brotherhood is quick to establish Vault Zero as its main base of operations. Although much destruction was wrought here, it still represents a massive storehouse of knowledge and technology. The ancient structure becomes the central hub of operations, coordinating between outposts far and near, and reinforcing their supply lines and transport routes across the countryside, ironically mimicking the original purpose of their defeated enemy. Recruitment and education of the local tribal and village populations becomes the all-important mission of the depleted and wounded Brotherhood. But the education is not one-sided. After generations of surviving in the harshness of the wastelands, the indigenous people are in tune with the land. They have valuable lessons to teach those immersed solely in technology, lessons of nature and balance that the Brotherhood had previously neglected. Not all of the wasteland's inhabitants are sharing the same noble purpose. Opportunistic raiders and bandits enjoy the fruits of a recovering, war-torn Brotherhood. Patrols are scarce and in smaller numbers than the thieves remember encountering in the past, as the Brotherhood focuses on consolidating its power base. Several frontier outposts are lost as the Brotherhood finds they are fighting a guerrilla war without the support of large numbers. But adversity and hardship are as familiar to the Brotherhood as discipline and knowledge, and they learn their lessons quickly. With a new power over this region comes a new responsibility. All plans for reestablishing contact with the West are postponed indefinitely. Recruitment begins anew, and the initiate ranks swell. All military efforts are then concentrated on uprooting all outlaw predators in the region, finally making it safe for the Brotherhood and its allies. In time, the Brotherhood once again rules the land. Resources are then allocated to expansion and development. Technology becomes more widespread, with irrigation systems established to make the nuclear-blasted land fertile. Humanity once again starts to prosper. The hero, the warrior of the Brotherhood, now a general, shares the burden and the satisfaction of overseeing civilization's development. The Brotherhood of Steel has come through the trials of this region and emerged scarred, but wiser. It will be decades before a reunion is possible between the old Brotherhood and the new Brotherhood regime. In that time, there are new alliances to be made, new battles to be fought, new victories to be had. But that is a tale for another day.